Let's start by talking about the Bearcats.
Well, it is a big task. That is a very good football team. It's been a very good program, and they had a super impressive start. I think they're averaging close to 600 yards a game. They have an outstanding system offensively, and they have good people running it. The quarterback is a tremendous operator, Pike, and the owner is a great talent, but they have a lot of guys to go with him too. So they are very, very impressive. It'll be a big challenge for us defensively, and then in special teams, kick coverage will be a major factor in the game because their returner is a really good player. And then offensively, we're going to face a very active, confident defense that has done very well early in the year.
Taking you back, kind of a bad memory of the game in Cincinnati. Statistically, it was crazy because you held them to 30 yards rushing. You outgained them. You had the ball a lot more than they did. You get beat by 31. Can you kind of talk about the way that nightmare unfolded in 07?
Well, I think in that game, it was one of those deals where they had a good offense, but we played terrific defense for a long time in that game. But you can't play as much defense as we made our team play that night. We were dominated up front by them, our offensive side of the ball. We couldn't run, protect. We made some plays and got some yardage, but a lot of it was late when we were way down. But I think it's going to be a similar game. We're going to have to do a good job offensively to help our defense because these guys are obviously very good, and so it's going to have to be a whole team effort. In all parts to turn around what happened from the last time we played these games.
Because of the way they play on offense, so quick, no huddle, does this pose a problem for a team that likes to rotate a lot of people in and out on defense, and obviously there was a couple of glitches in Vegas?
Well, absolutely. I think that's one of the reasons for going no huddle is to keep you on balance and not let the substitute situation or personnel-wise. I think we can still do it, but we, again, obviously have to do a better job of communication and getting people in and out of the field.
Were they calling it any differently or looking at that closer mic, or did you guys just, because it's
no.
It was uncharacteristic for you guys to have 12 men.
It was, when it happened to us defensively, it was total communication error. It was our fault, and we have to rectify it ourselves.
Mike, I look at these numbers, 78.6% for Canfield completions out of the Ethernet League Nation House. Can you talk a little bit about what he's done this year, his improvement since even a year ago?
Well, I think that there's a couple of good things, and I hate to talk about it, but we haven't turned the ball over and we're throwing for a high percentage. We, however, have, in my mind, have sputtered.